I'm standing here in Dublin, St. Fintan's Cemetery in Howth, at the graveside of Philip Paris Lynott, born 1949, died 1986. The graveside is a real memorial and testimony to the love that people had for this enigmatic Irish rock figure. Phil wasn't born in Dublin, nor did he die in Dublin. Although when you read his lyrics and listen to his music, Dublin and Ireland permeated his work and thinking. In fact, Phil was born in the West Midlands, in Birmingham. I'm standing here at the corner of Bournebrook Road and Rattlebarn Road in the Selyoak district of Birmingham. I'm standing outside St. Edward's Roman Catholic Church. And we're here because it was here that Phil Lynott, as we understand it, was baptized, having been born in Birmingham. We don't know all the details yet, but we're going in to talk to the parish priest and hopefully to have a look at the baptismal records. I'm now inside St. Edward's Church with parish priest Father McGillicuddy, standing here by the baptismal font where Phil Lynott would have been baptized.
You're very welcome, Paul, and it's nice to be able to talk to you about Phil. He was baptized in this font shortly after he was born, but in actual fact, the font would have been located at the entry of the main door.
Let's go and have a look at where the baptismal font would have been.
Yes, certainly.
Now, Father, do you know who Phil Lynott is? Does that name mean anything to you?
Not a lot, but I know that he was a writer, a poet of some standing. Yes. from the area. But apart from that, no.
So we're now entering the porch. Where would it have been in here?
Exactly on this spot here against the wall, you can see the outline of the octagonal shape base, still the print on the tiles when it was moved maybe over 25 years ago.
Right. So this is the very spot where the infant Phil Lynott was baptized. Now, could we have a look and see if we could identify when that was?
Yes. This is the registers of the baptisms took place. You can see here Lynott.
Ah, yes.
And he was born on the 20th of August 1949, and he was baptized on the 4th of September 1949. Philip Lynott.
There's this inscription at the side which says Woodville. Now, what does this mean?
That means that Philip was born at the mother and baby home just across the road, which is now the present St. Mary's Hospice.
Thank you very much indeed. I'm going to go now and have a look at the place where Phil was born. We are now a few hundred yards away from St. Edward's Church. We've just walked here and we're standing outside what is now St. Mary's Hospice. And the reason we've come here is because, as we have discovered from the baptismal register, this building was then called Woodville, and it was a home for unmarried mothers run by the Sisters of St. Paul, whose headquarters is not far away in Selly Park. And so we've come full circle from the final resting place of Phil Lynott to the place where Phil Lynott began his life.
The Sacred Heart is bleeding.
Friday evening in Dublin, standing here at the corner of Henry Street and Grafton Street, where the statue of Phil Lynott stands, a life-size bronze that was unveiled in 2005.
Dancing in the moonlight, it's caught me in its spotlight. It's all right. Dancing in the moonlight on this long hot summer night.
If you're in a hard rock and you don't know Phil Lynott and you don't know Thin Lizzy, you know, you're not a rocker. Anyone growing up in Dublin involved in the rock music scene had to be influenced by the likes of Phil Lynott, and everyone absolutely adores Thin Lizzy.
The more we have explored Phil's life and times here in Dublin, the more we realise that he brought a very strong and powerful legacy. And besides the bronze statue and the various plaques, the greatest memorial is really in the minds and the hearts of the Dublin people, who call him Philo and feel that he is really one of the true Dubs. So with the fine drizzle of rain falling on this warm afternoon, here with the flowers and trophies that surround Phil's grave, we come to the end of an interesting journey which started in a nursing home in Birmingham, ended in his house in Richmond, and brought back here to the place where he grew up and which influenced so much of his work, Dublin, for his final resting place. Phil Lynott, we salute you.